Yo, man, yo, fuck with you, Born Angry Fan, that little summer nigga, man. Shout out to those fucking Angry Fan, man. What up, nigga? You good? Man, I'm good, I'm alive, I'm breathing, man. Yo, check this shit out, B. First and foremost, hit my description box, you know what I'm saying? We got the clean paper interview. He's talking about his upcoming A-Verb battle on Black Ice Cartel. Y'all niggas, check that shit out. We got the Murder Mook. He's recapping Loaded Lux vs. Charlie Clips. Y'all check that shit out. We got Smack. He's recapping SM5. Y'all check that shit out. We got Arsenal talking about the G-Man Frost battle with the whole altercation and shit he gave inside on Angry Fans Radio. I got the battle description about the guy Arsenal winning. That was a wild battle. Almost got crazy and shit, you know what I'm saying? I actually spoke to one of the bouncers and she pretty much co-signed Arsenal's entire story and shit, you know what I'm saying? So it's like, y'all check that shit out. Yo, my niggas be. My next battle, I'm gonna get into some new battles. Like, yo, let me recap SM5, because I'm bugging out. Everyone's hitting me up. Like, it was been storming all week out here. Everybody who's in Charleston, South Carolina, man, shout out to y'all niggas. Y'all got it bad. I thought it was bad where I'm at. Like, y'all niggas got it bad. They got the water covering them in the hood of the car where they at. Like, crazy flooding. That shit's happening in South Carolina and North Carolina right now. So it's been raining all motherfucking week, B. That's why I didn't do the recap. I'm gonna give you my quick SM5 breakdown, what I got, you know what I'm saying? I'm gonna be real, number one. I was like everybody else. I'm not even gonna front. I didn't think it was gonna be that crazy. Cause the big names wasn't on it. But I already knew what time it was. Like, once you see Loaded Lux versus Charlie Clips on there, you can't expect to see Verb, Serve, Hitman. They're not all gonna be in that car. They already told you they're not spending that much content, all that bread for big ass cars like that. So once you see Lux on there, then you gotta automatically eliminate them niggas. I mean, you're not gonna have both, straight up and down. So anybody who wanted Lux back, this is why the card was the way it was, you know what I'm saying? Rex versus T-Top. Yo, number one, let me say this, B. Rex did his fucking thing. I'm not even gonna front, B. Rex did way better than he's been coming and shit. I'm not gonna jump on the bandwagon yet and say, oh, he's back, no. That nigga lost enough battles to the point that he can give us some good, consistent battles before we jump on the bandwagon with the old he's back situation. Fuck all that shit. He gotta give us some more battles before we can really ride that route, you know what I'm saying? But Rex definitely did his things. I edged Rex, I believe, round 1 and 2 and 3, I gave it Top. The reason why Top got this shit, I'm gonna tell you why. He played chess with Rex. Rex came with a whole bunch of street talk all 3 rounds, whereas Top was listening to the fans. All y'all niggas would be saying the same shit, like, yo, I'm getting tired of him, and all he do was talk about drugs and struggling shit. He was listening. That's the reason why he came with mad personal, and he was trying to do flips and shit like that. You know what I'm saying? Like, he was trying to show you niggas that he can do other shit besides drug talk. That's what he was trying to prove to y'all niggas. And that's what caught Rex off guard. But when it's that close, then it comes down to the personal haymakers, and that's exactly what T-Top had. You know what I'm saying? Real shit. I think it was a dope battle on both ends, but I gave it to T-Top 2-1. Johnson and Don and Wavy wasn't shown in the stream, but everybody said Johnson and Don, like, annihilated Wavy. Like, they said they annihilated that nigga. And then Wavy was in an interview where he said he acknowledged that he lost anyway. You know what I'm saying? So that was that right there. Hey, yo, what y'all think about T-Top, though? Let's keep it a buck, my nigga. Like, he done battled the best Suge we seen. He battled Clips, and now he got Rex. Like, who does this nigga battle next? What are we doing with Top? Are y'all still looking at this nigga like he's an up-and-comer? Because he's clearly proven that he can hang with these niggas. Clear with the main niggas. He's definitely getting comfortable with the main stage. You know what I'm saying? Real shit. Let me know what y'all think about T-Top and shit. DNA and K-Shine versus Themes and Chess. Shout out to K-Shine for the fucking Angry Fan bar in the first round. You know what I'm saying? I love that shit. The movement, my nigga. We made some of Madness 5. You know what I'm saying? My radio show ain't fucking trash either, motherfucker. You know what I'm saying? But on the real though, yo, that was a dope battle right there. I gave DNA and K-Shine. Yo, Chess and Themes, I'm gonna be real with you niggas. Be like, y'all don't need this 2-on-2 shit. It's not like... Like, I think y'all gotta start looking at this shit like this. Like, Chess just had a fire battle with Rum Nitty. Like, he's been having mad dope battles. You know what I'm saying? He don't need this 2-on-2 shit. Neither do Steams. Steams, you just had a battle with YK. Like, y'all are already doing y'all thing. So, don't get too caught up on this 2-on-2 shit. Because if you look at it, the only negative shit that niggas can say about y'all right now is because of the 2-on-2. If it wasn't for the 2-on-2, then y'all niggas would be on top of the world, but that is what's bringing y'all niggas back. I don't really think y'all need that 2-on-2 shit. Just leave that shit the fuck alone. Like, whatever, bro. Y'all tried it, whatever. You lost DNA, K-Shine. That's not some shit that now I think everybody needs to be doing. You don't need it. It doesn't really help your status that much in my eyes. You know what I'm saying? You want to take care of you first, straight up and down. So y'all might want to think about that shit. I'm not saying y'all trash no shit like that, But at the end of the motherfucking day, like, that 2-on-2 is not building your status up like that, my niggas. For real, for real. You know what I'm saying? I think it was a dope battle, though. Chess is nice, B. But to be real with you, if this goes to show, you know what I'm saying? Y'all had an interview where y'all was talking about they didn't have no chemistry. To be real with you, it looked like y'all didn't have no chemistry. Like, both battles looks like y'all kind of don't have the chemistry. Them niggas are actually comfortable together. It's y'all that's not. You know what I'm saying? I got them with the clear winning shit. Suge and Big T, I'm hearing that shit is fire. I can't wait for that battle to come out. Everybody's saying that shit is a fucking classic, but they're saying Suge might have edged that shit. I can't wait to see that shit. Tay Rock and Calico, my niggas. Now, at first, I had Calico winning, because there definitely was levels in this shit. Don't forget we interviewed him. There's definitely levels that Calico was trying to say. He was talking that shit that was like, oh, shit. So at first, I had gave it to Cal. I think I might have even said 3-0. Was it 2-1? I don't know. But after rewatching that shit, my nigga, mad times, like, nah, B. I'm giving Tay Rock rounds 2, and I got him slightly edging round 3, B. Like, yo, y'all niggas better stop fucking with Tay Rock, B. Stop getting that nigga mad. Look at how he turned up in that second round. That nigga went fucking ham on Calico the second round. But look at that ant and them and synonyms. Yo, the way he did that shit, the conviction this nigga had was crazy, my niggas. Like, he was just wild. And it wasn't even about him stopping and barking on Calico. It was just like every bar he spit, like, that nigga was trying to kill that nigga, B. There was conviction behind every fucking bar this nigga had, B. So I had to give this nigga round 2. Calico had a dope second round, though. But Tay Rock from beginning to end of that second was just spastic. I don't know what a turducken is. I guess this nigga talking about turkey and duck and chicken mixed in a bowl. I don't fucking know what that is. That shit I be talking about, Tay Rock. You always give us one bar that is totally fucked up and makes no sense. You know what I'm saying? But, you know, you got so much other shit that I can act like I didn't hear that shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, you do it with the money scheme sometimes. It's like, you always fuck something up somewhere in the battle. But this battle was so dope that I don't even care about that. The third round, the reason why I edged Tay Rock and not Calico, I feel like Calico's first half of his third was lackluster as fuck. But once it hit midway to the third, that nigga started cooking, B. But Tay Rock was cooking from the beginning of the third to the end, B. And it was just like, yo. And Tay Rock was trying to talk to that nigga and shit. You know what I'm saying? So I actually edged Tay Rock. I actually want to break all these battles down individually too and shit. But I know y'all niggas waiting and shit. You know what I'm saying? But Tay Rock did his fucking thing. No bullshit. What are we doing with Tay Rock, B? What are we doing with this nigga? Like, he's not just battling mid-tier no more. Now it's Calico. He battled Surf. He battled Cliff. We gotta start keeping it real now. You know what I'm saying? Like, this nigga Tay Rock has dead-ass tilt decline from the basement. Everybody knew this nigga from getting body bagged by Charlie Cliff. Look at this nigga now, B. This nigga is a monster right now. He came a long fucking way. No bullshit, B. Shout out to that nigga. Fucking, Miss Hustle and Official, yo. I gave a battle to Miss Hustle, you know what I'm saying? Clearly and shit. I think Official was dope, though. She had bars and shit, but it's just like, you know what it is, B? The crowd actually does dictate these battles, B. Like, look at these battles. They're like an hour long now because y'all keep stopping these niggas and shit. Y'all fucking up their momentum, their flow. If you don't fuck with them, then you're fucking up their confidence because they wait. They expect y'all to fuck with them, and then when I don't, they, like, Official's up there looking like Jazz when she battled her and shit. Like, she ain't really know what the fuck was going on. The crowd just wasn't fucking with her. And at the end of the day, man, if the crowd's gonna dictate the battle, that's whack, my niggas. Like, that shit is trash. Straight up and down, that shit is whack, B. You know what I'm saying? And it's really starting to fuck with the battle more and more and more. But on the upside of things, it's like, when the crowd is fucking with you, it gives the battles an extra boost to go even harder because they know the crowd is fucking with them. They know they shaking the building with mad people in the shit. You know what I'm saying? So it's like a gift and a fucking curse, B. But I gave it to Official. I still think she was dope. What y'all think? I see Lick Love was talking shit, and she was talking about she's gonna kill Official with bars and out pretty her, some shit like that. Do you niggas think that this battle's gonna fuck up her crown battle versus Lady Luck? Let me know what you think about that. All right. Loaded Lux versus Charlie Cliff. Now, my nigga, I be going back and forth with this. First, I had Cliff's winning. And I see right now, B, I'm not really the biggest Loaded Lux fan. Like, he's all right, cool. I fuck him. I respect everything he's done for battle rap, no doubt. You know what I'm saying? I really just didn't like all the Hollywood shit he was doing in all the interviews and shit, making it seem like everything was about bread. I really hated that shit. So, he lost a lot of points for me right there. You know what I'm saying? But I see now, in this battle, Loaded Lux is the type of nigga that'll lose the battle but win the fucking war. I think if you look a year from now and mention this battle, you're gonna remember more shit that Lux said than what Clips said. And Clips came. Like, this was a good Clips right here. But there's a reason why I gave it to Lux. Round one, I would've gave the Clips, but like, yo, I'm not gonna lie to you, B. Danny Myers did a breakdown of both their first rounds. Loaded Lux had so much shit in that first round. Let's think, Loaded Lux talked about the Mav fight, the Cortez and D Chambers joint, his mother, his father, his brother's father, him being a janitor, him fucking in a cheddar house situation with the $750. Him, like, he spoke about so much shit, it don't even fucking make sense, my niggas. You know what I'm saying? And Clips has some dope haymakers. Don't get it fucked up, but it's just like, it was too close. And I honestly feel like this too, my niggas. They were battling two different type of battles. Clips is more used to the modern day, modern stage battle right now, so he knows that joking around and having haymakers is going to have crowd reaction. If you listen to him in the second round, he clearly goes, oh, second round I won. He goes, oh, I got way more crowd reaction than him. He's right, he's writing for the crowd reaction. You're gonna get that with punchlines and schemes and shit. Whereas Loaded Lux, I think he's writing for the YouTube, how they've been doing it. You know what I'm saying? Like, he had, it was like that. It was a URL battle, which was Clips versus the King of Harlem, which is Lux, where all he really gave a fuck about was what was being said. He didn't care about the regular shit. You see what he said? Go, oh, yeah, you can clown me. Whatever, man. That's what you do, you entertainment shit. He's not thinking about that. He's thinking about the substance that he got in his bars. You know what I'm saying? Straight up and down. I edged to Lux off the strength of that. That's why I said I want to break this battle down again. The second round, Charlie Clips went like 3 minutes and some change, my nigga. It's a 5 minute battle. Like, I don't know what to say about that, my nigga. Like, come on, bro. Like, we've been promoting this shit for mad long. He should have had 5 minutes, man. You can't expect to go 3 minutes and change and think you won the battle, B. You just can't. You know what I'm saying? Straight up and down. And then, it's you're going short. Plus all the extra diva shit that was on Lux part with the whole coin flip. I thought that shit was mad corny and shit. They was doing all this. This nigga Lux got fucking 50 million pairs of clothes on and shit. Now, what Lux should have did, he should have did what Holler Don did, which was when he battled Hitman Holler. When he kept switching his shirts every round. Now, if that nigga Lux had wrapped the first round in the hoodie, then had the preacher shit underneath, then had the Harlem Hustler shit underneath, that would have made more sense than you getting up there doing all this extra shit, because niggas don't even give a fuck about that shit. They really just wanted to see the battle. You know what I'm saying? But all in all, I gave Lux the second round. The third round. Now, a lot of y'all niggas that gave Lux the third round because of the paperwork. Me, personally, I thought that shit was mad corny. Niggas is doing way too much to expose niggas, and that's the reason why battle rap is going to die any fucking way. You know what I'm saying? Straight, but now, it's supposed to be about bars. That's just it. All this extra shit, niggas are doing this way too much. A fight could have broke out. Charlie Clips should have pushed that nigga off the fucking stage who had the paperwork any goddamn way. Since he wants so much attention, he should have pushed that nigga off the stage. Yo, the niggas in my Facebook group too, I even inboxed and told him, I said, my nigga, I probably would have shoved you off the stage. You were doing too much right there, you know what I'm saying? But I didn't give Lux the third round because of the paperwork. I actually wanted to give that to Clips on the strength of that. I gave Lux the third round because of the reaction that Charlie Clips gave. Charlie Clips, he scrapped his entire third round. He scrapped that shit just to rebuttal what Lux had just did. What he should have did, or just did with, went with his regular third round, probably would have been mad haymakers, and he probably clearly would have won, because that paperwork shit was whack anyway. But that shit got him so flustered. You see him, he's freestyling. He's talking about your pops told a psychiatrist. Like, what are y'all talking about, my nigga? Like, what are you talking about? We just want to hear bars. Y'all was doing too much there. The battle should have been way better, in my opinion. That they were acting real deep, like, from the start, from the corn toss, you know what I'm saying? Clips, and he's talking to Lux while he's rapping. He's doing the fake yawns, you know, the shit that he always do when he act like it's not hurting him and shit. But in reality, he's getting hit with haymakers and shit, you know what I'm saying? Fucking, what else is corny? Lux's sister, she's making Lux rap and is overriding Smack. Like, where's Beefy? Like, Smack is a nobody and shit. The whole shit was crazy, and it should have been better. That battle should have been better. The end of the day, these niggas are battling to be the GOAT, greatest of all time. We ain't doing no rematches. It was a one-shot deal with this battle, and I don't think that shit was as good as it should have been. It wasn't even the battle of the fucking night, my nigga. Tay Rock and Calico was the battle of the fucking night, and it sounds like Shots and Shook and Big T might be right there behind it. Like, Lux, y'all niggas should have did better. Y'all can't be sitting here selling out venues and doing all this promotion, and you on Hot 97 telling Evil to come watch, and it's just like, I mean, it's not like Lux had mad crazy shit. It was just that he crafted all three rounds for Charlie Clips. Charlie Clips had a lot of setup that could have been said towards anybody in reality. That's what really, it was so close. That's what really made me lean towards Lux. It's just like, yo, this nigga's really writing for Clips. And he's scheming and doing all of that shit. Whereas Clips is that he got a lot of, like the Uber act. That was a dope punchline, but I mean, my nigga, this nigga sitting here saying all kinds of shit about you. He's a cornball. Wait. We knew this nigga way before, y'all. Like, that shit was crazy. Lux was trying to assassinate this nigga and spit on his soul. That's what he was trying to do for Cliff. And I don't think that Cliff had the same ferocity going back at him. I thought that Cliff looked at it like, all right, I'ma battle how I always battle. So what if it's Lux and I'ma win? But in reality, it's like, it's not always about that crowd reaction. I think Lux is just doing too fucking much. So that's the reason why I got Lux. Not because of that paperwork shit. That shit was corny as fuck. But it flustered Clip so much that he scrapped his entire third round. You know what I'm saying? Straight up and down. So that's my quick recap. I'm going to break the battles down again one by one. Fuck with you, Born Angry Fan 007. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to Angry Fans, real to the team. I had to rush these shits. I know you niggas waiting and shit. You know what I'm saying? I'll be acting a fool. Got some more tools coming and shit. But hit me on Twitter, Angry Fan 007. Follow me. I'll follow back. Hit me on fucking, you want to join the Facebook group, Angry Fans Radio, for all those who support the radio station. Yeah, y'all niggas searching on Facebook, you'll find it. Fucking hit me on the Gmail, AngryFan007, I respond to you niggas and shit. Fuck with me, my nigga, I'm back, you know what I'm saying? We got mad cards coming up. We might start doing my prediction blogs this week for them and shit. I'll see you niggas soon, man. I'm out. One.